have studied the general science. Till 8th standard, from 1st to 8th standard, you have general science. Now, in 9th standard, you have science and technology. There are two sections, part 1 and part 2. Part 1 mainly includes physics and chemistry, and part 2 includes biology and EPS. Now, the first lesson of section 2 is classification of plants. First, last year we have studied Whittaker's five kingdom system of classification. In that, Whittaker classified all the living organisms into five kingdom. Which are that five kingdom? Kingdom Monera, Kingdom Protista, Kingdom Fungi, Kingdom Plantae, and Kingdom Animalia. So, out of that four kingdom, in this lesson, we are going to learn in detail about Kingdom Plantae. So, what is the Kingdom Plantae? All the green plants which produce their own food by the process of photosynthesis. These all plants are grouped in Kingdom Plantae. What is the special feature? Kingdom Plantae broadly classified into two main groups. According to, if you observe around us, there are few plants which do not bear flowers. They do not have flowers. And there are few plants which bear flowers, they have flowers. So, according to that characteristic, whether they have flowers or not, flowers are present or absent, plants are basically classified as a cryptogam and phanerogam. What is meaning of crypto? Try to understand meaning. Cryptogams means non-flowering plants, and phanerogams means flowering plants. So, again, these cryptogams are divided into three basic groups. Halophyta, bryophyta, and tetrophyta. So, one by one in this lecture, we will first learn about the characteristics of cryptogam and other characteristics of three basic groups. See first, halophyta. The halophyta groups mainly grow in water as they are growing. If you observe in pond, lake, small lake or pond, there are filamentous green color plants are there. Fiber like filamentous structures are there. That plants are the thing looks Spirogyra algae. That all algae Spirogyra group into halophyta. The basic characteristic feature of halophyta is these plants mainly grow in water. Second characteristics, they do not have no same use. We have observed the plants in the water, they do not have root same use. They are the filamentous structure, scale like structure. So, the next characteristic is filamentous body. Their body is fiber-like. Next, most of them, they are autotrophic. Meaning of autotrophic means they can produce their own food by the process of photosynthesis. They have chlorophyll so that they can produce their own food. So, the characteristics of halophyta in short are mainly they grow in water, they are autotrophic, they can produce their own food by the process of photosynthesis, and they do not have roots their use. The basic characteristic feature is that they have filamentous or fiber-like body and green in color. Mostly algae are grouped in halophyta group, but few fungi like yeast, mold, aspergillus, these fungi are also grouped in halophyta, but the fungi are heterotrophic, they cannot produce their food. So halophyta have all the algae, but few fungi are also included in halophyta group, so they are heterotrophic. Next is bryophyta. Bryophyta are also called as the amphibians of the plant kingdom. What is meaning of amphibian? Generally, we use this word for animal who are living on land and in water both. Similarly, these plants are also called as bryophyta because they grow in soil but need water for reproduction. They grow in soil but need water for reproduction. Therefore, they are called as the amphibians of the plant kingdom. Second characteristic, they have thallard multicellular structure. What is meaning thallard? We have observed there are certain plants whose leaves are fleshy, they are thick. So this is called as a thallard. Next, they are multicellular and autotrophic. They can produce their food by the process of photosynthesis. Rhizoids are present. Root stem leaves are not present, but root-like structures are present. That structures are called as a rhizoids. If you observe figure, in that figure we can observe rhizoids are there, root-like structures. Example is Funaria mergentia. Next group is Pteridophyta. Pteridophyta plants generally observe around us. Many plants do not bear flower. For example, like fern plant. Fern plant is also called as ornamental plant because ornaments means jewelry. Ornamental it is called as because fern plant's leaves have black color spots behind the leaves, and that black color spots behind the leaves looks like a beaded necklace. So fern plant is called as a ornamental plant, which is included in pteridophyta. Many plants are there which do not bear flower, but they have roots, stems, proper structure, spores are produced, that all plants are grouped into pteridophyta. The special features of pteridophyta is roots, stems are present, special conducting tissue like xylem to conduct water and phloem to conduct food are present in pteridophytes. Next is they reproduce by spore formation, as flowers are absent in all Halophyta, Bryophyta, Pteridophyta, but they can reproduce by the process of spore formation and by the zygote formation. The characteristic features of all three will be Halophyta, Bryophyta, root stem leaves are absent, but in Bryophyta, root-like structures, rhizoids are present. Next characteristic, Halophyta mainly growing water. Bryophyta are called as the amphibians of the plant kingdom, as they grow in soil or need water for reproduction. Next characteristic, root stems are absent in both Halophyta and Bryophyta. Example of Halophyta is Pyrovera, Anthocereus, Alva. Example of Bryophyta is Fumaria, Mergentia. Example of Pteridophyta is Fern. So we have learned all the basic characteristics of cryptogam and three subgroups of cryptogam, as Halophyta, Bryophyta, Pteridophyta. Next period we will see detailed characteristics of phenogams.